Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another rage video where today, ladies and gentlemen, well, I should say tonight because it's already starting to get dark out, and you know what's slightly good about this is that it feels kind of right we're doing this sort of song at night, because it will be our very first time listening to the Claypool Lennon Delirium. Now, if you are with us, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll just go over briefly the rules for first timers on this channel. Any new group we do, we just get straight down to business. We don't hang about. And just at the risk of what I found to be quite interesting is that, well, without knowing anything off the top, I just kind of like really like get started, because I heard this song, the majority of, I'd say, Claypool's soundtrack, I think, has to do with Astronomy. But just in case it doesn't, I want to just check out at least what the monolith of Phobos is all about. Because I do know Phobos is meant to be a Mars that circles... a moon, I should say, that circles Mars, I believe. Well, we'll find out for ourselves if the monolith gives us any answer. So, if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. Let's begin. The Monolith of Phobos in 3, 2, 1, and... Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was the Monolith of Phobos by the Claypool Lennon Delirium. I'm going to go on a little bit of a limb here, ladies and gentlemen, and say that this is just like Jeff Wayne's musical rendition of The War of the Worlds, that this is designed to be a concept album of itself. But the thing is that if it is meant to be a concept album, I suppose, where does technically the Claypool Lennon go after this? Do they continue by telling this story about Buzz Aldrin? Because the idea, I think, behind this song is that there's meant to be obviously some monolith on one of Mars's moons, and Buzz Aldrin is waking up at night because he wants to have this investigated, and he has absolutely, because it's playing on his mind that there could be something out. Also, again, how ironic it is that I did this immediately after The Eve of the War by Jeff Wayne's musical rendition of War of the Worlds, because both concern the planet Mars, and maybe somehow they might find something. They might possibly have found something on Mars. And I don't know technically where this story goes, and I don't particularly want to look into it too much to ruin what's going to be coming next, because I'm just gonna briefly check what the rest of the songs are gonna be. I don't know whether or not they also like share that same that same theme of space exploration, because I've said for the longest time now, probably since I did my first reaction to Ginger, is that I would love nothing more than to see songs about space exploration, including but not limited to when I did my reaction to Nightwish's Shoemaker, because really the whole of I think it was Human Nature, Ad Astral, Earth 2, or whatever their recent album was, it revolved a lot about nature and space exploration. But I wouldn't mind checking out again if for no other reason than Claypool Lennon have got me a little bit intrigued with their very unusual, it's underplayed, their music is what I think it is. But maybe that's just because they want the air of mystery to sort of like fill up the vacuum of space outside. And that's not surprising how underplayed it is, because I'm going to assume this entire album is composed purely of two people, Les and Sean Lennon. Sean Lennon, I should say, does vocals, drums, and a mellotron, whilst Les writes and he does lead vocal. Well, I suppose lead vocals makes sense, and bass guitar. That's an awful lot to sort of like take in, but I think having a bass guitar is just, it kind of works to this strength, and just, it's underplayed, something you want to play in like a quiet environment. And I'll at least give this another go to maybe do, what was it, Cricket and the Genie, just to find out if for no other reason then whether this is still worth investing into, in the same way that like Blues Pills is worth investing into, if that makes sense. So let's see where this goes. I'm intrigued. I really am. So just, we'll see exactly what Sean and Les have got for us next time, shall we? And whether or not Buzz really did, they really do fill out Buzz's request to see if there is if there is a monolith on Mars and what it technically means. So anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction video. Please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. Let me know what you guys thought of the Monolith of Phobos by the Claypool Lennon Delirium. Please also make sure to also like and subscribe to get daily notifications when my videos come out. And I hope to see you guys again in the next reaction video. Take care. Bye-bye for now.